Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install MinGW and run your first C++ program, and also how to set up Visual Studio Code for C++. So let's get started. So just go to Google and type download MinGW. You'll be getting this sourceforge.net, and here you'll be having MinGW. Just click on that, and here you can see that it has about 4 million weekly downloads, so it's completely trustable. And here you will also be having download button, and here also you'll be having the instructions for downloading. So just click on this download button. So the download is completed. Just click on open, and you'll be getting this MinGW installation manager setup. Just click on install. Here you need to select the directory where you want to install. If you want to change it, you can just click on this change button. So I have changed the path, and I'll just click on continue, and I have these things checked. Okay, just click on continue, and our download process will first begin. So once everything is downloaded, just click on continue, and you'll be getting this MinGW installation manager over here. And in this, we need to basically check all the packages that we are going to install. So I need to just click on this checkbox thing, and I need to click for mark for installation. Okay, come to the next one, check it and click mark for installation. So do this for everything except Fortran. All right, we don't need Fortran compiler, so just do that for everything except that. If you want, you can also do that, it's totally up to you. If you think you are going to work with Fortran in the future, you can do that, but except that I will go for every other thing. So once you're done selecting, you need to click on this installation option, and you need to click on apply changes, and here just click on apply. So the installation will begin now. Once the installation is complete, you will be getting this message: all changes were applied successfully. You may now close this dialog box. So I'll just close this, and also I will close our MinGW installation manager. So now we need to add the MinGW path to our environment variable. So for this, we need to go to the folder where we have installed MinGW. So for doing that, the simplest way is just go to search and just type MinGW. You'll be getting this MinGW installation manager app. You need to just click on open file location, and here also you'll be having this. Just right click and just click on open file location again. So it will directly take you to the folder where you have MinGW, and here in the top you can see right MinGW is there. Just click on that, and here you'll be having this bin, and just select this entire path. I hope it made sense. It's basically the default folder where you have installed your MinGW. In most of the cases, it's going to be C, MinGW and bin. All right. So just select that, copy this, control C, and just go to search, and now type environment variables. Just click on open, and in this, click on this environment variables, go to path, click on edit, path under system variables, click on new, and just paste it. It's going to be local disk C or D MinGW/bin. All right. So I'm just clicking on OK everywhere. Yeah, here also. And now go to search again. And this time we are going to type command prompt. And let me just now zoom in. So it's going to be, and I will just type G++ space hyphen hyphen version. And if I just hit enter, so we will be getting this G++ MinGW version over here. So in case if you aren't getting this, and if you're getting G++ is not recognized or some kind of error, it means that you haven't added the right path to your environment variable. So make sure that you have added the correct path there. So now we are done with the installation of the compiler. So now let's go and run our first C++ program. So just go to Google and type download Visual Studio Code. You will be getting the first link over here as codevisualstudio.com. Just click that. And here you will be having Visual Studio Code for different OS. There is for Windows, Linux and Mac. I'm going to download it for Windows. So I'll just click on this Windows. Okay. So download will get automatically started. So it is about 88.8 MB in size. So just be patient. So once the download is complete, just click on open. And you'll be getting like this license agreement. Just click on I accept. You can just scroll down and read it. Next. So this is the location where Visual Studio Code will be installed. So if you want, you can just browse and change the location. I am fine with the default one. Just click on next and next as well. And here you can like create a desktop icon, and it's always good to have this one. Just check this. Okay. action to Windows Explorer. Yeah, better to give check everything and just click on next and install. Such a simple installation process, okay? Yeah, so once the installation is done, just click on launch Visual Studio Code and click on finish. So this is the first interface that you will be getting after you launch Visual Studio Code. So you can like change the theme. There is light, dark contrast, light contrast, dark. So after selecting the theme, you'll be having here file option at the top. Just click that and let me just go and open a folder. So I'll directly go into desktop and I'll just right click and create a new folder. I will just name it as C++ project. And I'll just click that folder and click on select folder. So now I will be inside that C++ folder and this folder is currently empty. It doesn't have any files inside that. So for creating a C++ program, here at the top near the folder name, you'll be having new file. Just select that and let me just type the program or the file name, which is going to be new pro dot. You need to give the extension as CPP for C++. And you'll be getting this small C++ icon over there and just hit enter. And here you can see we are getting at the top newpro.cpp and we will also be getting the C++ here. Like it has automatically detected our language. And also here you'll be getting a pop-up saying, do you want to install the recommended C/C++ extension? Just click on install and this C/C++ extension pack will get automatically installed and it is from Microsoft.com, so it's absolutely legit. And in case if you aren't getting any pop-ups like that, you need to go to this extensions icon and you need to just go to the search over here, remove everything, and you need to search for C++, and you'll be getting the first option as that one, and you need to just basically click on install if you aren't getting any recommendation pop-up like me. So once you're done installing the extension, it's always good to, you know, close and reopen your Visual Studio Code. So let me just now close and open it again. And next thing is regarding the size of the font. So just go to this manage, which will have a settings like icon. Select that and you need to go to settings. And inside this, you need to change the font size. Okay, you can have 30 to 40. That's like quite a decent size, I would say. And now let's begin to code. So it's going to be ash include. We will be getting this autocomplete and IntelliSense once we are done installing our necessary C++ extensions and also restarting our Visual Studio Code. So you want to do this both. It's going to be IO stream and the next line is going to be using namespace std and it's going to be int main. Let me just have a cout and let me go with hello C++, not the world. I'm done with this now. Yeah, saving it. So there are two ways to run this program and I will show you both the ways. So first way is through the terminal. So for opening the terminal, what I would recommend you to do is you'd be having this file, right? You need to basically just right click on it and in this you'll be having an option called as open in integrated terminal. Just click that. And the main thing that you need to note here is that you need to have your C++ project's path over here. So here you can see, right, C++ project. I'm having this C++ project over here. And inside that folder only, I'm having my C++ file and program. So you need to be careful that you are inside that particular folder. Okay, make sure that you are doing this. And after that, you need to run the command G++ space your program name, which is new pro in my case, with the extension. So it's going to be .cpp and just hit enter. So this will basically compile our program and it will generate this output file, which is a.exe over here. So for viewing this output, we need to just run this output file. So for doing that, it's going to be ./a and just hit enter. So here you can see I'm getting hello C++. So let's see the second way. Let me just clear the terminal CLS. Yeah. So for the second way, we need to have an extension called as code runner. So again, go to extensions and this time you need to search for code runner. Yeah, this one, just select that and you need to basically install this one. So you can see the number of downloads, right? I think it's around 20 million. So it's trustworthy. And once you're done, again, you need to just restart your Visual Studio Code. So now I am done restarting my Visual Studio Code. So now the main thing is that you need to have two extensions. One is this C++ extension pack, and another thing is you need to have Code Runner. And after doing these things, just close it. Here you will be having this run code. Okay, so you need to just click on this run code, and you'll be getting the output over here. Hello C++. Yeah, you just saw that, right? And in case we want to make any changes, I'll just go with hello world, and if I just save it, you'll be having this run icon, and near that you'll be having these three dots. I would recommend you to go with run code. Okay, don't click on debug or something, just click on run code. And here you can see, if I scroll down, I'm getting hello world in my output. Okay. But now you can see I am getting the output in my output console. I'm not getting in my terminal. So what if you want to view the output in the terminal when you're clicking on run? So for doing that, you need to go to file, and here you'll be having option called as preferences, and you need to go to settings, and you'll be getting the settings over here, and just click on extensions. And in the extensions, you will be having something called as run code configuration. Click that, just scroll down, and somewhere if you scroll down slowly, you will be having this run in terminal. Yeah, whether to run code in integrated terminal, you need to just check this one. Alright, and just close this, and no need to restart your VS Code now. Alright, and if I just now, I think I can directly click on run. Yeah, this is just run code. So I'll just click on run code, and here you can see, right, I'm getting the output in my terminal itself, and it is by default run code. So if it's not default by run code, you need to just click on this. Okay, so that's it, guys. This is basically how you configure Visual Studio Code for running your first C++ program. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a ton of C++ programming tutorials, as well as programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, CRUD Operations. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.